وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
How do we keep ties with a family member whom we suspect of performing magic? Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salam ala abdillahi wa rasulih Nabina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. So it's very, very important in this question that we distinguish between two different situations. The first is certainty and the second is suspicion. As for suspicion, suspicion is not allowed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Qur'an, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اجْتَنِبُوا كَثِيرًا مِنَ الظَّنِّ إِنَّ بَعْضَ الظَّنِّ إِثْمٍ. All you who believe, avoid a great deal of suspicion. Indeed, some suspicion is sin or is sinful. There is no doubt that just suspecting a family member of performing magic, this is something that is, you cannot take actions to cut off from people based on suspicion like that. Rather, what you should do in a case of suspicion is to be careful to protect yourself with the various adhkar and means of protection, keeping to your prayers, taqwa, following the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and all different things that protect a person from calamities in this world, and particularly the things that protect a person from the harms related to magic and the jinn. However, you obviously take that seek that protection from Allah azza wa jal, and you take the measures that are needed to protect yourself, but you can't go further than that into cutting off from the person based on suspicion. As for when you are certain, and certainty you have absolutely no doubt of it whatsoever, then the initial sort of stage is to advise the person, to warn the person, to tell them how serious the situation is. And then that person can be avoided in order to protect yourself. But if you can stop that person from their oppression through advice, through commanding them to fear Allah Azza wa Jal, through admonishing them, then this is better. Because if you can stop them from what they're doing, it will help a lot of people. If you can't stop them from what they're doing and you're absolutely certain you can avoid this person in order to protect yourself, but be careful, because the vast majority of these situations is a situation of suspicion rather than certainty. It's a matter of a person being, I have a feeling. And ultimately, that's just playing into the hands of the shaitan. Keep away from that suspicion. Protect yourself through your adhkar and continue to keep ties with that person, continuing to advise them and so on. It's only when the matter becomes certain that you can take an extra step. And Allah Azza wa Jal knows best.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.